Thank you. Commission on Recognizing Black History Month 2020. Whereas the national theme for Black History Month 2020 is African Americans and the vote, highlighting suffrage of blacks throughout American history. And whereas Black History Month first originated as part of the initiative by writer and educator Dr. Carter G. Woodson, who launched New York History Week in 1926. Woodson proclaimed that Negro History Week should always occur in the second week of February between the birthdays of Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln. And whereas, even before the Civil War, three black men first petitioned state legislatures for right to vote, but it was not until 1870 that this was accomplished. And whereas, on February 7, 1870, the 15th Amendment was ratified prohibiting the federal government in each state from denying a citizen the right to vote based on that citizen's race, color, or previous position of servitude, giving black men the right to vote across the nation. And whereas, just under a month later, the first African American vote was cast in Princeton, Illinois, New Jersey, on March 21, 1870, by Thomas Mundy Peterson. And whereas, although the 2020 theme of Black History Month, African Americans and the vote, recognizes the struggles for voting rights and rights of black men and women throughout American history, it's unfortunately an ongoing struggle for people of color that continues into the 21st century. Now, therefore, be resolved that the Mayor, Gary R. McCarthy, and the Schenectady City Council do hereby call to make deliberations to recognize the 150th anniversary of the 15th Amendment, 1850, and the month of February 2020 is Black History Month in the City of Schenectady. I'd like to move the resolution.
Second, I'd like to propose that the motion is passed. I'm in favor. The motion is passed. Thank you, Mr. Mason. Second resolution is recognizing the division of the next on the board of the 101st year anniversary of the College of Students and member of Passley to present.
Thank you, Council President. Resolution. It's a resolution recognizing the week of women voters on its 100th anniversary.
You have to
Thank you. Whereas the League of Women Voters was was founded in 1920 as a mighty political experiment by the four mothers of the suffragist movement and the National American Women Suffrage Association. And whereas their goal was to help the 20 million women who were granted the right to vote by the 10th Amendment understand and carry out their new responsibility as voters. And whereas with the success of this effort, and the tireless efforts over the last 100 years to strengthen and uphold its mission to empower voters and defend democracy, the League has become a trusted nonpartisan grassroots organization. And whereas the League has sponsored legislation and fought in courts to protect and strengthen voting rights and access, and for free and fair elections, civil rights, children, community health, and education. And whereas the League has consistently been noted for its nonpartisan election information, including sponsorship of candidate forums and information on state and local ballot issues, as well as its commitment to register, educate, and mobilize youth voters. And whereas the League champions government systems that are open, transparent, inclusive, and equitable. And whereas the League believes that active and engaged citizens, irrespective of gender, ethnicity, or political affiliation, are the hallmark of democracy, now therefore be it resolved that the Mayor, Gary McCarthy, and the Schenectady City Council do hereby pause in their deliberations to recognize the League of Women Voters on its 100th anniversary, and we commend the League, Schenectady League, as well for its significant contributions to empowering voters and making democracy work. I'd like to move this resolution.
Second by Ms.
I'd like to thank the City Council of Schenectady. This is a resolution recognizing that Kenneth James Sanders just recently graduated from the FBI National Academy, where on December 20th, 2019, Lieutenant James Sanders of the City of Schenectady Police Department achieved the designated honor graduating from the FBI National Academy, FBIAM, as a part of the 278th session, completing the rigorous academy, where the command officers are nominated due to their demonstrated leadership qualities, thus joining the ranks of other Schenectady Police Department FBI academy graduates, the U.S. Police Chief Eric Clifford, Session 274, Assistant Chief Mike Seaver, Session 197, and Assistant Chief Jack Fowler Jr., Session 219. And whereas the following nominations to the program by Police Chief Clifford and the FBI, and Lieutenant Sanders completed graduate level courses pertaining to leadership, media, psychology, and intelligence theory, and enduring demanding fitness challenges, including Yellow Brick Road, which involved a 6-mile run over 3 frustrated windows and crawling under black glass obstacles. And wireless Lieutenant James himself described as an amazing experience that has provided him with advanced sensor knowledge. He looks forward to utilizing these new attributes to assist the continued effort to make the Schenectady Police Department one of the most professional in the nation. And whereas, in the words of Police Chief Clifford, the FBI National Academy is premier executive training for law enforcement. Completing the training and joining the global network of law enforcement leaders shows the dedication Lieutenant Sanders has towards improving the leadership and operation of the Schenectady Police Department. On behalf of the agency, I congratulate Lieutenant Sanders on his professional accomplishment. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Mayor Arianna Coffin and the City Council do pause in their deliberation to honor and congratulate Lieutenant James Sanders for his accomplishments and dedication to the welfare and the protection of the City of Schenectady and its citizens. I'd like to adjourn.
Thank you.
which was 50 feet of sidewalk without a choice. So you went from 22, 42 to 27, 72. And, you know, there's no discussion of an explorer as to what makes sense to you. And I think other people need to know what's happening and what that makes sense for them to look at this project again. So, I would hope that I just would really like to thank the city council and the mayor for the support and adoption of the pavement connection and how completion is done. This has really been an amazing process that was done by the CDPC, the Capital District Transportation Commission, Mayor Jacob Beaver here, and also in that a lot of engagement from the residents and people within in the Hamilton Hill and Pleasant areas, and we look forward to the implementation of this transformational project. That is really the unit of the physical bridge and the social bridge that strengthen bonds and empower access and connection between Hamilton Hill and Mount Pleasant. So we're just really excited by the process. We really see this as the community's vision that's reflected in design. And we thank everyone for their support and everyone who's here tonight in support of the plan. Thank you. Thank you. served in the Second World War. His father served in the First World War. And his ancestors served in the Civil War. Because of people like them, every American has inherited the right to speak any place in this country. What happened to me in this chamber on January 13th was worse than traveling with razor blades. Anyone responsible for the key lockdown should try it. January 13th was a bad day for safety. An indelible mark was made on its history. Democracy was abandoned. A summons was given to parliamentary procedure. Another's private space was invaded. Hostility reared its ugly head. And all past resolutions given to veterans to Veterans Day were reduced to nothingness. For shame, for shame, for shame. The major things we have is not so
thank you. Next speaker is Executive Director of the
Department. It is very good to be here to talk about the population of women. Good evening, Mr. Mayor. Good evening, Dr. Green, Mr. President. But to this point, I'd like to mention that the community is here. The building complex building several students meeting for quite some time. When they've been open for quite some time, and they know they're going to be there, they do a good time. Be precise. I'm not going to talk about anything that's been charging women. I'm trying to make sure that they're charging better. There are many of you that are probably familiar with the complex because they deal with quite some time and they do really well. Now, if someone who has been running in the building, they just don't get there. If you're a fighter, I'm not going to get it. And if you're a fighter, you're going to get it. I'm sure you're going to get it in my own story. I'm going to get it. 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 Now, if you're going to get it, you can have a job for people like, I'm going to get it. 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 And you have to start out with these things like that. Now, the only thing that I'm going to do is to take a look at the system of the country, the government, and the business person. And to get that feeling, you want to have a lot of money to pay your country for a couple. You want to have a lot of money to pay your country for a couple. You want to have a lot of money to pay your country for a couple. You want to have a lot of money to pay your country for a couple. Let's take it. Okay.
Thank you.
suggestions from the best teachers. I don't think we got them. So that's what I think we got 200 millions out of us the first year. But of course, right now, at the end of the third year, we still only have 169 million. That's not the shortfall of last year. It's 25% of what is projected for 2018. That's not transition. Thank you.
immigrants in Schenectady. Touring is a special just in the so my idea is this. Only Canada and Japan, only these dollars, that wants to come here to the city of Australia to make business. They want to meet a bunch of people. They want to meet a bunch of people. To this party is a requirement. That is the they need to request some percent of that money to that part or transfer some percent of that money to another part for the creation of another museum or a museum for another.
Thank you.
make sure that we keep the light up and for March 1st. We take all the retailers or institutions out not to use the price of 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 the
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.